Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Big Braithwaite Quiz number 31, the special Easter edition. Ha ha! I got me special vocals as well. There we go. It's like being at the optician. Hang on. Right. Is the green strip or the red strip brighter? Is the excellent brighter or smaller? Should have gone to Specsavers. Well, as we said, happy Christmas anniversary, Easter, my dears, as we come to the final quiz of 2000 and mental. Many of you celebrating out there saying, thank God it's the last one of this crap, right? So I'll just check that I'm coming out. I might be talking to myself, I just need to check that I'm here. So give us a wave if you're or send me a message. Send me a message from the depths, from beyond. As you can see, we've done ourselves up for a bit of a festive do. Oh, yes, there I am. There, who's that idiot in the glasses? Right. Right, so, as we said, the final one. I can't. 31 weeks. We started this 31 weeks. And some of you have been here for all 31. My condolences. And I hope the therapy works. I hope the therapy, it's not working on me, as you can tell. Now, before we carry on, we got a very serious before, because this week we lost one of our brave servicemen who served their country for many years, and they did 35 years with the British Legion, working as a chairman and the local British Legion, and it's Mr. Brian Green, and sadly lost him this week. And our thoughts go out to Phil and Denise and all the family. And thank you, sir. Thank you for your service, sir. So with that, no mind. Now, another one who's been... I don't know if you remember last week. If you weren't here last week, we had a lookalike. We had a tribute. A tribute to Victor. Because Victor started getting a bit of a diva. So we brought in a tribute. Not so good. Turns out it was pretty rubbish. So we got, yes, all right, Victor. I know you told us so. No, yes, I know. Nobody can replace the real thing. Oh. Thank goodness this is the last one. It'd be unbearable. Yes, all right. So at the end of the show, Victor is going to sing one of the songs off his album. Victor does the musicals, except it's going to be a Christmassy one. He's going to do a nice Christmassy song to take us out of the show and out of the series and out of the year. So he's going to be singing that, the whole version. I don't think anybody's going to cut him off. He's going to do the whole version and he's going to sing it live with some music as well. Getting very professional. Are you, Victor? Getting very professional. I thought it was Elton John on the screen. Standing by for Christmas. Right, so as normal, we got a lot of questions and a lot of music, but it's all Easter related, all to do with eggs. What? That's what I said. I said Christmas. No, I said Christmas. I did not say, why would I say Easter? It's Christmas. Get your ears plugged. Right, so as we said, a Christmas theme in the quiz today, so all the questions and all the music is Christmas related. There we go. Is that all right now? Thank you, Victor. Right, because let's face it, he's not very happy. He's not very happy, are you, Victor? We gave our Christmas presents out today, and I gave him his. He wasn't happy because I gave him a broken drum kit. He wasn't happy. He went into a strop. He wasn't happy. I said, that's a broken drum kit. I said, you can't beat it. You can't beat. No, he didn't see the funny side either. No, I don't. I'm going to get myself a new writer, typewriter. Right. So here we go. Welcome for the final. And they're all saying, for God's sake, get on with it. Right. So here we go. Have we got anybody before we do? Anybody? Right. Trevor. Hello, Trevor. I think we must have got a newbie. WTF? What's that mean? What that for? Oh, WTF, what that for? Yes, that's... Welcome, Trevor. Welcome to... You're lucky. You're lucky. There's been 30 more of these and you've missed it. You're one of the lucky ones. Paula, love the specs. Thank you, Paula. Sue, hi. Hi there, Sue. So our reigning champion, Sue Horan. I don't think she can be caught now. She's a bit like that Lewis bloke in the Grand Prix. She can't be caught. She's been declared the winner of the season. What that for? W2F. I think that's what it stands for anyway. So, anyway, here we go. So we got some normal Christmassy questions, and then we got the music questions. So are we ready, Victor? Are we all plugged in? Have you make sure you put 50 pence in the meter? We don't want it running out halfway through like it did the other week. Number 30. Would you believe it? Number 13. Quiz number 13. Technical problems all the way through. We had to stop after 10 minutes and somebody sabotaged worked. But it would be number 13, wouldn't it? That's uncanny. Uncanny. Right. So here we go. Oh, I've got some. That's the music one. Right. So here we go. Question. And that was the news at 7:06. Right. So number one in the song Frosty the Snowman, what made Frosty come to life? Oh, there's another one, isn't it? In the song, Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy. What made Frosty come to life? Oh, you're all sitting there singing through. Oh, that's, yes, you got it. Number two, who played George Bailey in the Christmas classic, It's a Wonderful Life? So which actor played the lead role in that amazing film? I don't think I've ever seen it. Never seen that one. I must sit down this Christmas and watch it. It's in the old grey and white thing, isn't it? It's a Wonderful Life. Who played the main role in that? Any more? Sue's scratching her nose, picking her nose. I didn't know you could get emojis of you picking your nose, Sue. That's very clever. Trevor's still sponged. Right. Losing me Elton's. Right, number three. What Christmas beverage is also known as milk punch? What Christmas beverage is also known as milk punch? As you might have noticed, there's a bit of a theme. There's a bit of a theme running through this. And that's Easter. It's Easter, isn't it? No, Christmas. Christmas. Number four. Which reindeer shares a name with the famous symbol of Valentine's Day? So go through all the reindeer. If you know them, do you know the reindeer's name? That would have been a good question. Why didn't you write that one? That would have been a good... Name all the reindeers. That would have been a good question. With lots of bonus points for Sue. Right. So which reindeer shares a name with a famous symbol of Valentine's Day? And Paula, can you see okay? No, I can't see okay anywhere. What, is there one? Is there an okay somewhere? And there's okay doesn't exist in my planet. Oh, so hello, darling. Love the look. Am I talking to myself here? Right. Number six. No, sorry, number five. I'm ahead of myself there. Number five. What Christmas themed ballet? My bit of ballet training there. What Christmas themed ballet premiere in St. Petersburg in 1892. I think Mrs. Braithwaite was just about born then, I think. What Christmas-themed ballet premiered in St. Petersburg in 1892? Been there, fabulous place. It's St. Petersburg, in I think it's in Essex. It's a wonderful place, wasn't it? Number six. Which 2004 film is about a train that carries kids to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? Oh, I'm sure a lot of you will have seen this. Which 2004 film is about a train that carries the kids to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? I've not seen that one either. What's that mean? I've seen Scrooge. I've seen Scrooge a lot. And Sound of Music. I've seen that every year. And the other Malcolm and Wises. I've seen them. Number seven. Why didn't they write this one in English, Sharon? Which much reviled, it can't be that nice. Which much reviled Christmas edible is also known for its long shelf life? I think translated in English, that means what food that you have at Christmas lasts a long time. There you go. Why didn't you just write that, Victor? You're getting too ahead of himself. You've had a dictionary for break. You've been having your alphabet soup, haven't you? That's what it is. Been having it. So, what famous Christmas dish is known to last the longest? Number eight. In Dickens' A Christmas Carol, what was Scrooge's first name? Oh. In Dickens' A Christmas Carol, what was Scrooge's first name? And it wasn't Mr. It wasn't Mrs. either. Anymore. Can I see okay? Yes, I can. I can see it now. That's a cheeky one. Georgie boy! George, a bit late. George, oh please, George, don't start saying, can you repeat number one? George is a bit late. George, what did I tell you? Make sure you pay the electric bill. I told you, didn't I? Make sure you pay that electric bill. Mr. Verse 5. You're trying my... As we said. So we'll rewind. And then we said, and then Victor, and then I said, and then we started the questions. I can't keep up. I'm getting too old for this game. Right, all right. So for George and anybody else who came in late, right, where's your note? Where's your note? You've not got one of those notes that said, excuse George for being late from school, but he was bilious. That's what I used to get. I don't know if Caroline or Kathy are watching this, but when we used to go to school, Gary was bilious. What the hell? Is that, do I survive that? Right, so question number one. What made Frosty the Snowman come to life in the song? What made, that was question number one. Number two, who played the lead role in It's a Wonderful Life? Which actor played the lead role? Number three, what is Milk Punch better known as? Number four, which of the reindeers was named after a Valentine's Day name? Number five, what Christmas-themed ballet premiered in St. Petersburg in 1892? Number six, which 2004 film features kids that go to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? And by now, it's Christmas Eve. Right, okay. So, number nine. What Bing Crosby song is the best-selling single ever? Oh, you must have got this. Even Sue must have got this. What Bing Crosby song is the best-selling singles ever? I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. No, no, it won't be that one. No. Any more comments? Missy, salute to the 1940s on your bike. George is a bit late. Billy who? Billy who? Oh, yes, yes, no, not Billy who. Billy us. Billy who? I sat next to Billy who. He wasn't a nice lad. Right, here we go. Number 10. Miracle on 34th Street. Fabulous film. I've seen that one. Miracle on 34th Street centres on what real-life department store? Oh. So there's a department store, I think it's in New York, that's featured in Miracle on 34th Street. Well, of course it would be New York, it's 34th Street. Which department store is featured in the film? Most of you must have got that one. Number 11. How many reindeer in the poem, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas"? Oh, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas." I was asleep. I missed it. I don't know. So how many reindeer are featured in the poem, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas"? Right. Number 12. Here we go. What traditional Christmas decoration is actually a parasitic plant? That's easy for you to say. That's easy for you to write. What traditional Christmas decoration is actually a parasitic plant? And I think I'm sat on it. I'm getting a lot of parasitics, I think. Oh, I'm struggling with the parasitics. Oh, excuse me. Where's my ointment? Right. Oh, no, missus. Right. Number 13. In The Muppet Christmas Carol, who played Scrooge? It wasn't a Muppet. It was a real living actor. What are those? Real living actors, these days. Back in the day, it's for all the children. Back in the day, they used to have things called actors and actresses. And they used to work, being paid to act in films. I wouldn't believe it. None of this CGI stuff or Androids or whatever. Yeah, I've had them as well. They're not very nice, them androids. No. They used to have real humans acting in films back in the day. Oh, I remember it. Well, there we go. So, yes, in the Muppet Christmas Carol, who played Scrooge? A real actor, a real living person. Number 14. What beverage company has been using Santa Claus in its advertising since 1931? I'm not there yet, are we? It's only 1917. It's not half past seven yet. So, which beverage company has been using Santa Claus in its advertising since 1931? As they have a big truck. They have a big truck. Oh, giving it away. Any more abuse? Sue Horton, lol. Hello, lol. Why do they keep calling me lol or WTF? What's that for? What's that for? I don't know. We've done that one, yes. All right, so number 15. What well-known Christmas carol became the first song ever broadcast from space in 1965? Oh, there's back in the old day. What well-known Christmas carol became the first song ever broadcast from space in 1965? And I'll give you a clue. It was a Christmassy one. It was Christmas, wasn't it? No, Easter. It was Easter. And number 16. What holiday movie sequel includes a cameo by Donald Trump? What holiday movie sequel features a cameo? Isn't that a soap? Isn't cameo soap? A cameo by Donald Trump. Later to become... What did he become? I don't know. So, yes. Donald Trump was in a movie. A sequel. Oh, that's all the hard ones. That's all the questions. That's George, and you were there for most of it, I think, weren't you, George? I'm not. Hello there, Mrs. Darling.
Hello. Have you done all your Christmas shopping? Have you bought anything nice for
Mrs.? Don't you go spreading rumours like that. You don't go giving her any ideas, but buying things nice for Mrs. Braithwaite. Don't you go putting ideas in her head. Oh. I'll have none of that. But I'll have some of your baked well pudding next time.
Oh, no, I'm going to do some mince pies.
Mince pies? Who wants? Nobody. Who has mince pies at Christmas? You don't. Victor, you don't have mince pies at Christmas. You do? You have mince pies at Christmas? That's strange. All right. Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mrs. Darling. I look forward to that with a bit of chocolate ice cream.
Oh.
Oh, now you're talking. Brand.
Some rum.
A bit of rum. A bit of rum on the bum. Yes. Why not? Oh, cheeky. But why not? Why not? Oh, thank you, Mrs. Darling. You're spoiling me. There goes another waistline.
I know. More calories.
No, she's not here tonight. Carol's not in tonight, is she? No, Carol's not here tonight. No, Carol is tonight. No. Carol is tomorrow. Yes. Where am I? Roger, are you still there? Get me out of here. I'm a silly Betty. Get me out of here. That's nice. Right. Okay. So it's the music. The music now. So for those of you who've just joined us, welcome to the Madhouse. And in this section, we play a song and you have to name the song title and the artist. But it's not as simple as you think. Because we changed it, or we've missed it all about a bit. Missed it all about. Because we have to, don't we? Get a slap wrist. So, any more? So, George, I've never been anywhere for most of it. Translated. You've not been anywhere. I thought you'd been on tour. Right. Paula, has she made you a Christmas... Oh, Mrs. Darling! She's gone. She's disappeared into the ether. No, she's making mince pies, Paula. Don't think she's made... Christmas cake, mince pies.
Did you want the list of it? Oh, yes.
Our viewer, one of the two of them anyway, is asking, have you made some Christmas cake?
No,
she hasn't, Paula. She hasn't made any Christmas, but I've heard the mince pies are big. She's got very big mince pies, that's what I've heard, right? Big mince pies, so that will make up for the Christmas. Thank you very much, Mrs. Darling.
Okay.
Thank you. Go on, have a lie down now.
Oh, I'm going in now because it's cold.
Oh yes. Oh, if you see those, if you see those monkeys walking around looking for their brass balls, just let me know.
Okay then.
Bye bye. Everyone say bye bye to Mrs. Darling. Right. Okay. So the first song is this one. So we want to know the song title and the artist. Song titles you'll get. You'll know most of these, all Christmassy ones. But it's who's singing it. Right. Here we go. Number one.
Yourself a merry little Christmas.
Name that tune.
Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight.
I think they're being a little bit optimistic there with that line. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. If there was ever a song so inept. That was it. But who was singing it? Who was it singing those totally out of order lines? And what was the song title? Right, so next one is this one. There we go. So song title and artist. Okay, now this. So this one is number 19. No, 19. Here we go.
I saw Mommy kissing Santa Claus underneath the mistletoe last night.
So who was that? You'll have got the title, but so what have we got? Sue Horton has made Welsh cakes. Oh. Welsh cakes, or I haven't been to Wales, so I don't know. Paula, what no? It's one of those, what no? No. Right, so next one is number 20. Here we go, number 20.
But King Wenceslas the Bell.
She sounds a lovely girl.
When the snow lay round about. Even Christmas even brightly shone the moon at night.
Get out of the carol singers. Here we go. So number 21. Everybody will know this one. All together. Doesn't matter what you do with that song, you're gonna recognise it like that. Arthritis, shouldn't do that, especially in this temperature. Right, number 22.
Oh, well, outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful, and since we've no place to go.
You got it. So that was number 22. Number 23.
Oh.
I was on my way then. That was sending me. Right. So that was number 23. Number 24. Here we go. 24. Slick,
hey, Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me.
No, for me.
And hurry down the chimney tonight.
The door's open. Why are you coming down the chimney? You come through the door like everybody else. Right. crazy man. Number 25. 25. Here we go. Oh. Ice cream man's here. Ice cream man. They'll never sell any ice cream going that fast. Thank you. Eric Morecambe.
Dreams of Santa, dreams of snow.
All together.
Number 26.
Oh, this will catch you out. My favourite Christmas song is... So that was number 26. Now, a lot of you probably got the song, but I reckon that it's the artist. It's got to be worth 2 points, that, because it's a very difficult one to get to guess this one. It's not one of your regulars. So it's actually our neighbour. It's Mrs. Darling. She was singing it. Mrs. Darling was singing that one. But, oh, Victor, I've given it away. No, it wasn't Mrs. Darling. But if you can name the artist on that one, you get 2 points. So there we go. And the last one, number 27. Here we go.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Who was that?
On the fourth.
I had enough of that one. Right, I'm going to give you another 2 points if you can name the artist on that one, because that was another bit of an obscure one, apart from the little in the middle there. Now, we haven't had... Now, that's all of them. That's all of them. But we haven't had Victor's favourite singer. And Paula. Paula likes him. But Paula, you like this one. And, oh, it's gone very quiet. It must all be very constipated out there. Concentrated. So, we haven't had Victor or Paula's favourite singer. And it turns out he's actually Santa's favourite singer. Do you know what it is? Elvis Presley. Elvis Presley. He's not laughing. Sorry about that, Mrs. Braithwaite. Sorry about that one, Mrs. Braithwaite. I'm talking... My God, Mrs. Braithwaite, you've lost a lot of weight. I can hardly see you. She lost a lot of weight. Mrs. Braithwaite, my goodness, can practically see right through you. Right. Okay. So I think there we go. So if you've all got your chalk and your slate, turn it over. Get ready to mark yourself. No, don't mark yourself. Mark your answers. Wait, because we trust you. I think after 31 weeks, we're trusting each other now. So just mark your own questions. Right. Victor's just bought himself. Haven't you, Victor? Just been out and treated yourself today. But he's bought himself a new present. He's bought himself a reindeer. He's been out and bought himself a reindeer. Can you believe that? But it's not very nice. It's not a nice reindeer. It shouts at you and it says nasty things. So he's called it Rudolph. Rudolph. Well, I like it. I like that one. I've never heard that one before. You like that? Oh, he likes that one. Rudolph. Yeah, but it's true. It's not a very nice reindeer. Rudolph, they're not nice reindeer. He would give you a thick lip. I got two already. So here we go. So he's gone very quiet. Where's all the abuse I normally get? I know we haven't got a couple of you here tonight. So they sent a note in advance apologising. So if you're not here, give us a wave. Let's hands up anybody who's not here. Oh, back to the old Panto. Oh, Panto, can't do it. Can't do all the Pantos. Closed after two nights. Mind you, I was in a panto that closed after two nights once. But I think it was, I was in it. I think that was the reason. We got seven people. I like my little head. So they're all ready for the answers, apparently. Right, so here we go. So, question number one. Are you ready? So, in the song Frosty the Snowman, what made Frosty come to life? And it wasn't Frosty's. Not Frosty's. Wasn't the tiger. It was an old silk hat. An old silk hat. Did you know that? I didn't know that, Victor. An old silk hat brought Frosty to life. Oh, there we go. So 1 point if you got... Did you get that one, George? Because I know you were late. And I rattled through the first five or six. Sue. What's that? What is that, Sue? What's that a picture of? What is it? I can't work that one out. I was at Specsavers today and I can't believe it. I don't know what that is. It looks like a teapot. A pink teapot. There we go, these glasses. Number two, who played George Bailey in It's a Wonderful Life? And it was, of course, Mr. James Stewart.
Yeah, my name's James Stewart. Yeah, I'm in a film called It's a Wonderful Life.
He sounds like George Bush. That's like my George Bush impression. My George Bush impression. George Bush was in It's a Wonderful Life.
My name's George Bush.
No. Number three, what Christmas beverage is also known as milk punch? And it's eggnog. Eggnog. Yuck. Eggnog. Number four, which reindeer shares a name with a symbol from Valentine's Day? And it is, of course, Cupid. Of course. What else could it be? Cupid. Not Basher. Don't have Basher. No, not on Valentine's Day. Right, number five, what Christmas-themed ballet premiered in St. Petersburg in 1892? And it was, of course, the Nutcracker. Well, I think they named it that because one of the moves they put in it was... when I was in my ballet training on that Saturday afternoon in 1926, I remember doing that one. So the Nutcracker is the answer to number five. George, no, I didn't.
No, you didn't. Didn't you? What are you denying?
George, what are you denying? I know what I asked you. Did you repay me that £50 I lent you? And you said, no, I didn't. So can you please send it back to me as soon as possible? Because now we've finished the 31 weeks. I've got to pay the electric bill. So, George, please. Now you just admitted, no, you, and we've got six witnesses. We've got six witnesses to prove that you haven't paid me that £50 back that I lent you. So please send it ASAP.
Right. And George Telford, yes, I did.
Make your mind up, man. Make your mind up. Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, no, this is the only place you're
going to get pantomime this Christmas. Everywhere else is shut. You got to come here. Oh, he's behind you. Oh, no, he isn't. Oh, shut up. Get on with it.
Right. We're whittling down. Oh, we've still got seven. We've still got seven to get rid of.
No, Victor. No. You've got to sing a full song in a minute. I don't want them all watching. I'm trying to get rid of them. Don't want them all watching you singing your song. Right. So here we go. Number six. We're only on number six. We're under 3 weeks ago, yeah? Which 2004 film is about a train that carries kids to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? So which 2004 film is about kids travelling on a train to the North Pole on Christmas Eve? And it was, of course, the Polar Express.
The train now leaving platform 3.5 is the Polar Express, but has been delayed till Easter due to snow on the line. Where do I get these things from? I don't know.
The next answer just about sums me up. Right, so number seven, what much reviled Christmas edible, meaning what food you have at Christmas, has a long shelf life, and it is, of course, fruitcake. How apt. Fruitcake, or I'll accept Christmas cake. I will take it, or a wedding cake, or birthday cake. I always accept any sort of cake. I will accept. In fact, that George, if that's what you've not sent me, then please send me the. Oh, I've heard Susie makes very good fruitcake. So if you just like to send me a big one, I'll sample it with pleasure. Yes, he did. Yes, so we moved on now. Oh, yeah, I see. Got Cupid, but then I would, wouldn't I? Yes, you're a very Cupid. Are we after the watershed yet? What a Cupid. No. Right. Number eight. In Dickens' Christmas Carol, what was Scrooge's first name? And it was, of course, Ebenezer. Ebenezer Good. Ebenezer Good. That was from the 90s. I've seen that one. Ebenezer Scrooge. Ebenezer Scrooge. Yes. Number nine. What Bing Crosby song is the best-selling single ever? If you didn't get this. I'm serious now. If you didn't get this, wipe off all your answers. Go back to the beginning. Go back to the start. Go. Do not pass go. Do not collect £200 and go straight to jail and wipe off all your answers. Because if you didn't get this, even I'm not that stupid. It's White Christmas, of course. White Christmas. What Bing Crosby song is the best-selling single ever? What did you put?
What? The Cheeky Girls? No, it wasn't the Cheeky Girls!
Bing Crosby didn't sing the Cheeky Girl. He sang with a few Cheeky Girls, but he didn't sing... No. It was White Christmas. Paula is playing golf. She's playing golf online. And watch out, everybody. She's just hit a ball. There we go. Well done. Good shot, Paula. Right.
Very quiet.
I'm not getting any abuse this week. I'm not used to this. Right. Number 10. Miracle on 34th Street centres on what real life department store? And it is Macy's. Macy's in New York is where they made Miracle on 34th Street. Number 11. How many reindeer are in the poem 'Twas the Night Before Christmas? Oh, there's my acting voice there. That's what George taught me.
'Twas the night before Christmas.
That's all I know. Only learned that bit. Sorry, George. Sorry. I'll pay you back. I'll pay your money back. So, 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. What was the question?
Oh, it's written down. Right.
The question was,
how many reindeer in the poem
'Twas the Night Before Christmas? And it is 8. We'll put 9. No. There's no Rudolph. Rudolph's not in it. There's only 8. 8
reindeer. Right. Number 12. What traditional Christmas decoration is actually a parasitic plant?
Is mistletoe.
Now that would have changed the lyrics, wouldn't it, for Cliff? Christmas time.
Parasitic plant and what? No. That wouldn't have been the same. Christmas time. Parasitic plant and wine. Children singing. Get rid of that plant! I don't think that would have been as big a hit. Right. Oh, Sue! Oh, it's applause. Thank you, Sue. I've just seen that. It's like that. Thank you very much. I got the clap. Right. Where are we? 13. Number 13. In the Christmas Carol, Muppet Christmas Carol, who played Scrooge? A real actor. No. It wasn't George. I think George should have. George is a fine actor. George, I don't care what anybody else says. I don't care what he says on all the... I think you're very good. I think you're a fine actor. It was, of course, Mr... Now, not a lot of people know that. Did you know? No, it wasn't Frank Spencer. Michael Crawford, no, it wasn't. Now, did you know I was in the Christmas Carol Muppet film? It was Michael Caine. No, it didn't sound like him. No, it didn't sound like him at all. I used to. Did you know, and not a lot of people know that, I was in the Muppet movie.
You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off.
I know that bit. I know that. There you go. Moving on.
Number 14. What beverage company has been using Santa Claus in its advert and in its commercials since 7:30?
And it is, of course, Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola. Other soft beverages are available. But it was Coca-Cola in the advert. Number 15. Well, well-known Christmas Carol became the first song to be broadcast from space in 1965. It was Jingle Bells. I didn't know that. Did you know that, Vic? No.
No, I didn't know that.
That's a new one to me. Have you been just making these up?
Have you just been...
So, playing April Fool tricks in December, making them up. No. Jingle Bells, apparently. First song to be played from space in 1965. Who put that request in? Mr. DJ. Number 16. What holiday movie sequel includes the cameo of Donald Trump? And it was Home Alone 2. Home Alone 2, not Home Alone, because then it wouldn't be a sequel. Home Alone 2 featured Donald Trump. Now I do my Donald Trump impression, but I can't do it. I can't do him, can I? No, I've been practicing earlier. Can't do him.
I can do that bit.
We're gonna be great. We're gonna be great. We're gonna be fabulous. We're gonna be the best. You're gonna be the best. No. Give up. George says it's very good. Thank you, George. Yeah, George likes my impression of Donald Trump. That's a big compliment coming from George Telfer. That's very good. The fine actor, George Telfer. Yes. No, stop. not ignore what everybody else says. He's a fine actor. Right, so now the music. The music is this. First of all, this one is number 17. Just my age. Well, I was 17 anyway.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
There we go. That was, of course, Have Yourself a Merry Little Easter. With lots of Easter eggs. Oh. Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas by, did we get the singer? No, it wasn't Bing Crosby. It was Judy Garland. Judy Garland. Number 18. I sing this one. I do sing this one. Not as good as this song. There we go, that was It'll Be Lonely This Christmas, especially for me. It'll Be Lonely This Christmas by Mud. Fabulous band. I remember Tiger. That's right. I really love your tiger light. That's neat. I really love your tiger feet. I really love your tiger feet. Oh, that takes me back. I lost myself in the moment there, Victor. I lost myself in the moment. Number 19. Who is this and what they singing?
I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus.
That's the title.
Underneath the mistletoe last night.
Yes, I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus. She's very strange. I'm not going to go any further with that one. I'm still waiting for my therapist to explain it to me. And it was by the Andrews Sisters. Was it Andrew's sister? Did she sing that? And Andrew Bartholomew. His sister sang it. And Andrew's sister sang that one. She's very good. She delivers our milk. She's our milkmaid. But, George, was last impression of Hugh Grant. Who are you calling a Grant? He's just calling me a Grant. He said Hugh Grant. I said, what is a Grant anyway? Is a Grant a good thing or a bad thing? Hugh Grant. Hugh Grant. I don't know. But I'll take it as a good thing. Thank you, George. Thank you. Next one. Number 20 is this one. Who is this one? I thought it was the National Anthem. God Save Our Gracious.
But King Wenceslas the
Third. You're giving it away now, you idiot.
When the snow lay round about, leaving Christmas even.
What a prize. Good King Wenceslas. Yes, King Wenceslas is the song title. And the artist, I don't know if anybody, it was actually Bing Crosby. Bing Crosby, believe it or not. He's the postman, isn't he? Our postman's called Bing Crosby. Yeah. So number 21, here we go. You've all got this one. This is another one of those. If you haven't got it, leave the room now. Of course, it's Merry Christmas, Everybody, not everyone, Merry Christmas, Everybody by Slade. It's Christmas. I actually met Slade. I did a show. I was in a tribute band, and we did a festival, and we were on the stage with Slade, and I met them, and we were doing our bit, and they were doing their bit, and I went up, and he said, "Pleasure to meet you, sir." And they said, "Who are you?" I said, "I'm in the tribute band." But very love Slade. I went to see them at the City Hall in Sheffield in 1926. A wonderful, wonderful band. But that was Merry Christmas, Everybody by Slade. I'm digressifying again. Right, number 22. I can hear them all shouting. Get on with it, you pillock. So they're waiting to hear you, Victor. That's what they're all just waiting. They don't want any of this rubbish. They want to hear you singing. There we go. What's it worth to carry to drag this on? Just fast forward. Right, number 22.
Oh, well, outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Sorry about that, folks. Yes, that was, of course, Let It Snow, but don't. Don't you dare. Mind you, we're in shutdown, aren't we? So it doesn't matter. I could just go and build a snowman. Yeah, Let It Snow by Mr. Meanie Darting. Dean Martin. Meanie Darting. That's like last week's Moni Tartin, isn't it? Moni Tartin or Facebook, which I got the wrong way around last week. Can't believe I said Facebook the wrong way around. Live on my laptop at 7:15. Right, so there we go. So that was by Dean Martin, Let It Snow. Yes, I know. Bit of an altercation there, because that is what Victor is singing at the end of the show. At the end of the show, Victor is going to sing us out with that song. But Victor, that's not as good as your version. Don't worry, don't panic. That your version is much better than that. Okay, right, so don't panic. It's very good. Very good, very good. I've got the effects as well. Got lots of effects. Spent a fortune, blown all the budget on the last show effects. So we've got lots of effects in Victor's last song. So here we go. Number 23 is this one. Haven't we had him already? No, we've not. No, we've not had him already. I thought we'd had him already, but no, we haven't. There we go. But have you noticed? All of these songs, they've got no imagination, because the title of the song is always the first line of the song. Good. So that one is Our Little Town of Harrogate. Our Little Town of Bethel. Our Little Town of Harrogate. How still we see the... No. Our Little Town of Bethlehem, right? Which was the first line of the song again. And it was sung by Blue Eyes, Mr. Moni Tartin himself, Tony Martin, or his tribute, Frank Sinatra. Frank Sinatra does a tribute of Mr. Tony Martin. I don't know if you know that, but it's true, it's true. Next one, number 24. And, I'm sorry about this, Mrs. Braithwaite. So, she'll be pulling her hair out. Number 24.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. In an awful big girl, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight.
They've done it again. The first line of the song is a title. Haven't they got any imagination? When they write these songs like they do these days, you name a song that's not even got that line in the song. That's what they do. They name it like that. But this one, Santa baby, that's what it's called. So no imagination. No. Santa Baby by
Eartha Kitt sang that one. I didn't know. I got it written in front of me.
Eartha Kitt. Right, next one. Number 25. Oh, it's one of our favourites. Yes, this was our question earlier, isn't it? What was it?
The cherries are king, the carol are sing. The oboe is fast, there's a new beginning. Dreams of silver, dreams of snow.
Parasitic plant, yeah, so there we go. Parasitic plant and wine, or mistletoe and wine will do. And that was, of course, by Cliff Richard, the fabulous Mr. Jimmy Germain, or Cliff Richard. So that was 25. Number 26. Now, if I remember rightly, we offered a bonus point on the artist because it was so obscure. If you got the artist on this one, then you get yourself 2 points just for the artist. So there we go. At least they waited for at least one line before they put the title in. They say they're getting a bit more imaginative now. They waited one line. Sleigh Ride, one of my favourites. I remember when we first started pantomime, that was our overture. We were all stood behind the blocks of wood. used to work behind blocks of wood. And the sleigh ride. I love that song. And that was Glen Campbell. Did anybody get Glen Campbell?
Very quiet.
Well, I already this is tinsel. I already it's given them all a migraine. Right. Oh, we're down to four. That was good. No, still no impression of Hugh Grant. Right, and the last one. Number 27 is this one. 2 points for the artist again.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 2 turtle doves and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Who was that? Right, so, at least, and again, they've waited till the very end of the song before they put the title in, because that was called the 12 days of Christmas. It wasn't called the first day of Christmas. It wasn't called the second day of Christmas. It wasn't even called the third day of Christmas. They waited until the end of the song, and they called it the 12th day of Christmas. Well done. Bravo. Bravo. So there we go. 12th day of Christmas is the title. And the artist, 2 points if you got this, was Perry Como. Perry Como. So if you've got Perry Como, give yourself a clap. And 2 points. Well done there. Well done. And that's it. That's the lot. That is the final question of 2000 and mental. I can't believe it. I can't. 31 weeks. 31 weeks. Oh, the ghost. I feel the ghost. I feel the spirits around. Right. Okay. So let's shout in your answers. Let's see if we've got our answers out there. So I think we can assume. That Sue has won this. Why spoil the habit of a lifetime? Because your main competitors are not here with us tonight, Sue. So you're pretty good, strong chance that you've got this. Because we haven't got any Kirsten or Denise tonight. So, in fact, we've only 4 of you. Oh, Sue got 25. All right, there we go. Paula got 24. Well done there, Paula. Very good, Paula. Very good. Paula, you got the silver medal. Caroline got 20. You've been very quiet, Mrs. Rendell. Sitting in your conservatory there. And getting she'll be writing in, joining in. So George got 12. George, bless him. But he's a good actor. Might be crap at general knowledge, but he's a damn good actor. If you get a chance to go and see George, good luck, because all the theatres are shut. So George got 12, Caroline got 23, Paul got 24, Sue Horton got 25, and anyone else? Caroline's alone tonight. You've got that on your own. Very good. It's because you were allowed to answer the question, you see. You didn't have Russell saying, no, it's not that, it's this, and it's wrong. No, no, you stick to your guns. Right. So far, Sue? So, any more for I go once, go twice. I'm away to finish the sleighs. That's the first time I've heard it call that. Right, well done them. You are very kind and possibly slightly deluded. Which song was that? I don't remember that. You are very kind. No, that was the wrong answer, George. Wasn't. No. That's why the good score. Yes, I know, Caroline. That's why you don't. So I think we can kind of happily say that Sue Horson has won the last quiz. Look at them, they're all cheering. They're all cheering, Victor. We're all cheering because thank God we aren't going to waste our Monday night. We can get back to watching Coronation Street. That's what they're all saying. So I'm away to have 3 weeks of baked well pudding of Mrs. Carolyn. Right, so the next time I'll be like that. Any more? Right, so there we go. Congratulations, Sue. We'd like to wish you all a very, very happy Christmas. And don't eat all your Easter eggs at once. Thank you very much for sitting through 31 weeks of this rubbish and putting up with my ramblings, as I often do. Poor Mrs. Braithwaite, she's now got to put up with all the ramblings all on her own, as where normally I vent them on you and gives her a break, but now it's all, I feel sorry for her. Send a donation in to Mrs. Braithwaite at 0891 725. Calls cost £3.50 a second and will not be returned. So, There we go. So thank you very much. Well done. If you get a chance to go see Mr. George Telfer in anywhere, then go and see him. In fact, just go around to his house. He'd probably do it in the garden. It's so true. Right, so Merry Christmas. Yes, they're all saying Merry Christmas. Remember that short film I mentioned to you? Oh my God, words like that, bullets and duds come to mind.
Explain it later, George.
Right, so we're going to finish now. We've got the music ready. Victor. Victor is going to take us out with one of his songs, because you all know. We tried the tribute last week. Rubbish. Rubbish tribute. Mind you, what do you get for paying 25 pence? So Victor is coming back this week. So, right, Victor, go stage left. Stage left. Go on. Right then. Excuse me. Right then, Victor. There's a joke. I'm not going to say that. Joke just came to my mind there, but I'm not going to say it. Right. So then, Victor, thank you, everybody. Have a very safe but happy Christmas. Be careful. Don't go hugging everybody. Just give them the old bump and be safe. And hopefully see you in leap year. Or just come and visit me at the hospital when they allow visiting time. Thank you very much. Good after evening. And I will leave you in the capable hands of Victor. Thank you very much. Right, Victor.
Okay, can I come out now?
Yes, you can come out now, Victor.
Okay. Can I sing my song?
Yes, you can sing your song. Right.
Okay, right. Okay, I'll put it on the floor, right. Everybody, I'd like to finish off the show and the season with this song. It's very appropriate, and I'd like to thank Mr.
Get on with it.
Right, yes, I'm going to
get on with it.
Right, yes, I'm going to start. So here we go with a wonderful song called "Let It Snow." Here we go. I'm so looking forward to this.